Hello guys, welcome to my channel Life at Germany with me Vino. In today's video we are going to see about different German offices which you need to get in touch once you reached Germany or once you wanted to settle in Germany and certain things needs to be done, then you need to approach these kinds of offices. Let's see what are these offices. Once you reach Germany, the first thing you need to do is city registration. So in order to do this kind of registration, like in which particular city you are staying currently in Germany and in which residential address you are staying in Germany, based on this you need to do this city registration. So in order to do this city registration, you have to contact city office in Germany. All these different kinds of offices are called as Amt. So you can say Bürgeramt. Similar to that, there are several Amt. Even when you want to change from one house to another house, then you need to do this residential change registration into the city office. So for this purpose also, you need to get in touch with city office. The same thing when you are changing from one city to another city, then you have to do the city registration in the next city which you are going to live. If you have a car and you want to park your car near to your residential area, then you need to get a residential parking permit in Germany. So in order to get this kind of parking permit, you also need to go to the city office. If you are planning to buy a car and you wanted to register your car in Germany, in that case you need to approach this car registration office. Welfare office. This is very important for all the families who came to Germany. This office is mainly for children and adults. It means when you are searching for a school, then you can approach youth and welfare office. And when you are looking for a kindergarten, you can approach this office specifically for child care. For example, in a family when both husband and wife both are working and you are looking for a child care option for your children, in that case you can approach this youth and welfare office and you can say that you both are working and you need some immediate support with respect to child care. So whatever related with the children, and if there is any request for adults, all these kind of consultation or information you can get from this youth and welfare office. Another example, when your baby is born in Germany and as a parent you want to apply for parental allowance, that is Elterngeld in Germany. If you want to apply for this Elterngeld, then you need to approach this youth and welfare office. One is employment agency. When you are looking for a job in Germany after coming here as a dependent, then you can register yourself in this office that you are searching for a job. Then the agency itself provide the information what is your next step to search for the job. Is financement, or you can call it as finance office. So once you register yourself in Germany, then you will get your tax ID and social security number from the government. So based on this tax ID, you will be registered into different tax classes. So if you are a single person, then you will be registered into tax ID or tax class 1. So if you want to change from one tax class to another tax class, then you have to approach this finance office. Initially, while coming to Germany, you came as a single person. During that time, your tax class is 1. And once your wife and kids, they joined you, after some days, then you need to change your tax class from tax 1 to tax 3. In that case, you need to approach this finance office in order to change your tax class. Also, you have to submit your income tax into this finance office so that for every year, the income tax will be calculated and the financial statement will be provided to you from this finance office. The next one is insurance office. So once you started working in Germany, then you need to pay your social contribution in Germany. So this social contribution is nothing but the pension services. So in order to discuss anything about your pension, then you need to approach this office in order to get the information. For example, if you are applying for permanent residence permit, in that case, you need to submit your pension contribution for the years which you worked in Germany. So in that case, you need to get the statement from this office. The next one is Public Order Service Office. So this office mainly works for public. For example, if you lost your mobile phone in train or somewhere, then you can go to this office, lost and found office, and there you can report like your mobile is lost, and if it is available there and you have provided enough information about your lost item, then you can able to find it easily from this office. Is also helpful in several ways. For example, if there is any fire emergency, then you can call to this office by using the number 112 emergency services. Very important. Once you reach Germany, you need to know this number very importantly. So 112 is the emergency number. So when you call 112 for any fire accident, then this company will send the fire service person to the house for an emergency. This office can be approached also for traffic reasons. If there is a heavy traffic, then also you can call to this office and inform there is a traffic at this particular place. Then they will send a person to clear the traffic. Then the next office is social service related office. So if you want to volunteer yourself for any social activities, then you can approach this office and they will guide you. The next one is education office. It is called as Ausbildung. So when you want to do any further education, like you want to attend a German language course, then you can approach this kind of office. So there is a Volksschule which is called as VHS throughout Germany. So you can make use of this school in order to learn German. So through this education office, you can go to the library and register yourself into the library and you can get your books or series from the library and make use of it. The next one is Environment and Consumer Protection Office. So anything related with the environment, like for example garden or a park, all these things if you want to approach, then you can go to this office, Environment and Consumer Protection Office. The next one is Health Department. So it is called as Gesundheit. So when you have any emergency to check in a hospital, then you can check the options with this office. There is similar to fire service, we told like 112 is the emergency number. Similar to that, if you want to contact where the emergency hospital is located or how you can go to that emergency service and so on, then you can call 117. This is mainly for health emergencies. So you can call this number. The next one, Family Benefits Office. So once you reach Germany and you have children, then you can register your children in this office in order to get the child allowance, that is called as Kindergeld. So you have to apply for Kindergeld in this office so that you will get child benefit from the government. The next one is Planning and Building Office. It means if you are planning to buy a property, either it is a house or if you are planning to buy a land, then you can approach this kind of office in order to get permission for a building or permission for the land, land registration or whatever it is. So you can approach this office for consultation. We are at the end of this video. So two main important things which you don't forget in Germany is always for any kind of emergencies, you can call 112 and 117. Don't forget it. Keep in mind, it will be useful at any time. So we have seen different offices which you need to approach in different situations in Germany. So once you reach Germany and if you face any kind of situation like this, approach to the different offices which I mentioned here. Once you reach Germany, don't worry that you are stuck where to approach, whom to contact. Please follow this video. Contact different offices based on your need. Always they are ready to help you and they help you to integrate very quickly in Germany. Okay guys, let's see in another video with other useful information. Until then, bye from Vino. Bye. See you!